It is from negative infinity, from our part, negative infinity to behavior for large X is the same as equal X square. When we draw the graph, we show for large X, it behaves like X square. Negative, for large negative and positive, it is positive. For a n less than zero, negative. Behavior like negative x square. Negative x square. We can draw. This is a big idea. For large x's. Because when x is large, no matter what is coefficient, x to the n will be always greater than other terms. And first leading term will be greater than other terms because x vary from negative infinity to positive infinity. And n is odd. Then leading coefficient positive, behavior like x cubed. X cubed. It means that for negative, it increases, large negative increase, and increase. Function increase and vary from negative infinity to positive infinity. A n less than zero, well, behavior is opposite. For negative, it is positive and decrease. For positive, it is negative. Mm-hmm. That's behavior. When we graph, we should show behavior for large axes. Make these lines show the behavior. For large axis. What intermediate value theorem state? Intermediate value theorem. What does it mean? What does it mean that function is continuous? This is true not only for polynomial function, but for any continuous function. Fx is continuous. What does it mean? Well, we know polynomial function take all values, no gaps, no holes, no jumps. Well, if we have two points, A, B. F, A, not equal F, B. And we take any value G between F, A, less than G, less than F, B. Intermediate value, value between two values which are not equal. What's the theorem state? Is this value is mandatory taken by any points? All values between two values which are not equal are taken by the function. It means that there exists point C such that FC equal G. Any intermediate value is taken by continuous function, like height, weight, temperature, pressure, all these functions vary continuously and all values are taken. No, for polynomial function are continuous functions. It means that if we have two points with when functions has opposite signs, the zero, at least one zero exists between these two points, mandatory. Now, for example, if F A is less than zero, F B greater than zero, so then G equals zero is between these values. So there is a point when this value is taken. F C equal zero. At least one zero exists between two values with opposite signs. So we can find zero approximately by division by half. Take the half, middle point between A, B, one of interval will have opposite sign. If it is not zero, it is positive or negative. So one interval will have opposite sign. Then we divide this interval again by two. And the same thing. One of interval, either we get zero or we get interval with opposite signs. And so we divide by two, at least we get needed precision, needed accuracy. This is a method of finding approximately zero. And what is reminder theorem state? Reminder theorem. We have polynomial function fx. We have any value k, number k. If we divide fx by x minus k, what we can say about remainder? Remainder of division. Who know what is remainder? Esther, what is remainder theorem state? It's remainder, it is f of k, the value of function in this point. No. And specifically, if remainder equals zero, it means that fk equals zero. So k is zero. Zero of polynomial function. And it means that it is divisible by x minus k. X minus k is a factor. And what is fundamental theorem of algebra step? How many zeros? If we can consider complex numbers and we consider polynomial function of degree n, how many zeros polynomial function has in general?
Zero or two?
No, if we consider complex numbers, the number of zeros equal n, exactly n. No, the theorem states that there is at least one zero under complex numbers. But if we divide by x minus c1, c1 is complex number, we decrease degree by one. And again, it is greater than one. Again, at least one exists. And so we decrease degree, at least we get polynomial of degree zero. Polynomial of degree zero, it is constant. Polynomial of degree one, it is linear function. It has exactly one x-intercept. For linear function, we have one y-intercept and one x-intercept. For quadratic function, we have two zeros. They can be both complex. It's what you say, no real solutions. We say quadratic equation has no real solution. But complex solution exists always. It means when we draw the graph doesn't intersect x-axis, but complex, if we use quadratic formula, we always have solutions, but it's possible that both solutions are complex. It means that our graph doesn't intersect x-axis, completely above x-axis or below x-axis. But solutions under complex numbers exist always, always two solutions. They can be both real numbers, different, or both real, the same, rational, irrational, or both complex. Is it possible to have one complex and one real solution of quadratic function?
Yes.
One complex and one real, you say it's possible. Maybe somebody say differently. One complex and one real, is it possible?
It's possible.
Let us refresh quadratic formula. I will write in general quadratic equation. Okay. I will write quadratic equation. Ax squared plus bx plus c equals zero. And I write quadratic formula. Minus b, we need to memorize this. We often use it. B squared minus 4ac over 2a. When complex solution appear, if under radical we have negative number. It's possible, it can be, but We have always two, we see plus, minus. Complex solutions are always conjugate. But we forget to say that coefficients are real numbers. That's what we say from the very beginning, that we consider polynomial function with real coefficients. Of course, if coefficients are complex, then everything can be. But if coefficients are real, complex solution always come in pairs. One complex and one real is impossible. However, it's good, it's good. The, if answer is incorrect, you still get points. What's your name? Who say?
Emmanuel.
Very good, very good. But now you see, if you look in formula, and if you assume that all coefficients A, B, C are real numbers, then you can see from the formula that complex solutions are always in pairs, conjugate pairs. It is minus B over A plus minus square root. And if under square root we have negative number, we have two complex solutions, plus minus conjugate. So if coefficient of quadratic function are real, then it can be only either two both complex or both real. It is impossible to be one real, one complex, because the formula shows that complex solution always come in conjugate pairs. And this is true not only for quadratic equation. For quadratic equation, we see this from the formula. For polynomials of higher degree, like third degree, fourth degree, we don't have the formula like this, like quadratic. But however, the same statement is true. If coefficients are real numbers, complex solution always come in conjugate pairs. This is true for any polynomials. It means that number of complex solution should be mandatory even. Now, for example, for cubic equation can be either all three real number, real zeros, or maybe one real zero. At least one should be mandatory, and two complex, because number of complex is even. It can be two or four or six or so on. And so if degree of polynomial is odd, it means that at least one real solution should be. And it follows from graph, because graph vary from negative infinity to positive infinity. Zero is between, so one zero should mandatory be. One real zero for any odd polynomial, polynomial of odd degree, three or five. They, we say domain, all real axis, and range, all real y's. It means that at least one zero, real zero should be. That's what we need to know. So if we consider complex number, the number of zeros exactly equal to n. No more than n, no less than n. Complex solution exactly equal to n. But number of real solution can be either n or can be less than n. Less than n by we subtract even number. Because if there are complex solution, mandatory two, at least two complex solution conjugate. Two or four. For polynomial of third degree, maybe either all three real or one real, two complex. For polynomial of fifth degree, can be either all five real or maybe one real and four complex, or three real and two complex. That's what can be. because complex solutions are always come in conjugate pairs. And from fundamental theorem, we can state linear factorization theorem. Now, if there are exactly n zeros, it means that there are exactly n linear factors. Factors of psi x minus c. We can present any polynomial of degree n as fx. If degree n, it can be presented as x minus c1, x minus c2. It is complex numbers. Real numbers is also complex. When complex part b is zero, complex numbers include real and imaginary and complex. X minus cn. And ci, complex number. And can we present this as a real factors? Yes, we can, because complex solutions are conjugate. So the product of two complex solutions is difference of squares, because two conjugate. No, for example, C1 and C2. Complex part has opposite sign. It will be difference of square. The sum, the product of sum and difference give us quadratic function x square minus c square. C I square. So any polynomial with real coefficient can be presented as the product linear and quadratic factors, because the pair of complex solution can be presented as quadratic function. But if we consider complex numbers, the number of solution exactly equal to n, to degree of polynomials. That's what we need to know. And how can we find real factors? If real zeros, if polynomial has integer coefficient.
I'm guessing you need the rational zero test?
Yes. The rational solutions. The product of all zeros, it is constant 10. If first coefficient an is one, then the product of all zeros is a zero. It is constant 10. But in general, it is a ratio P over Q. P are factors of A zero. Q factors of A one. We can list, write all factors of A zero, including one, plus, minus, and all factors of AN. Well, we can see the specific example of this. set degree polynomial fx equal minus 2x cubed minus 5x squared plus 4x plus 3. Well, if we write the factors of a zero of 3, it is plus minus 1 plus minus 3. An factors of an, it is plus minus 1 and plus minus 2. Well, let us try. Now we see that 1 is a factor, 1 is a 0. Because if we substitute x equal 1, we will get 0. The sum of coefficient minus 7 plus 7 is 0. It means that x minus 1 is a factor.
All right. So in order for you to figure this out, you know, you're checking the last number and the first number, correct?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Now we can take 3 over 1.
And to add up. Add it up.
One over one. It is a 0. X equals 1 equals 0. It means that x minus 1 is a factor. We can divide fx by x minus 1. We will use synthetic division. The procedure everybody should be able to do, synthetic division. We write 1 with plus. First coefficient we bring down. Zero, that's it. Now we can write the quotient. It will be minus 2x squared minus 7x minus 7. And we can solve, find 2. Now we can solve this by factoring. Write 2x squared plus 7x plus 3 equals 0. When we have coefficient not equal 1, we can use quadratic formula or factoring. Now we divide by 2. Is plus. And we get x plus 3 and 2x plus 1. We write without denominator. And we have two solutions, x equals minus 3, x equal minus 1 over 2. That's it. Now we have three zeros, minus 3, minus 1 over 2, and plus 1, 3 zeros. Or x-intercept. Now we look at leading coefficient. Leading coefficient is negative. First of all, we define behavior for large axis. It will be for negative, it will be positive. For positive, it will be negative. Arrangement. Label axis. Many people don't do it. X, Y. Label. Make same spaces for both axes. The spaces should be the same. Zero, zero. And mark the negative 3. This will be first. Negative 1 over 2. And positive 1. That's our zeros. And then we can graph. Let's sketch. 1, 2, 5, 0. Number of turning points is 1 less. Oh. Y-intercept equals 3. Go to y-intercept. And that's it. This is a sketch, this is a graph. The similar problem will be in our midterm. Well, now it is easy, one. Well, sometimes it is more difficult to find. I will do another example. Any questions about this? When we graph, first of all, we define behavior for large axis. Then we mark zeros. Now three zeros are real numbers. And graph. Y-intercept and x-intercept should be shown on the graph by numbers. I will write another example. 3x plus 3x cubed 2x squared minus 19x plus 6. Well, now we will write what are zero. It can be a zero has plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 3, plus minus 6. Many. And a n factors plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 3. Now we see 1 is not good, minus 1 is not good. We'll try. No, we will try negative 3. Substitute negative 3. Negative 27 times 3, negative 81. Plus 18. Plus 57 and plus 6. That's okay, equals 0. So negative 3 is F. negative 3 equals 0. So negative 3 is 0. So we can do the factor x plus 3 is a factor. We do synthetic division. First coefficient is always the same. Then we write minus 9 plus 21. That's correct, 0. Remainder is 0. That's it. Now we write 3x squared quotient minus 7x plus 2. Equals 0. Again, we can do this plus 6. We can solve this equation by factoring or by quadratic formula. X minus 6, x minus 1, divide by 3. X minus 2, 3x minus 1. And we have two solutions, x equal 2, x equal 1 over 3. And we can write the zeros, negative 3, 1 over 3, 2. Origin, axis, xy, 1, 2, 3, the same spaces. If you have the notebook with lines, you can have two spaces for between two lines. And keep approximately the same in horizontal direction. 1, 2, 3, approximately. And we mark behavior for large axis will be like x cube, negative, positive. That's what we mark. Negative 3. One, over 3. 6. Y-intercept should be marked exactly 1 over 3 and 2. values. Ah, that's what my mistake. 1/3 here, positive. Nobody, so you should keep at me. I make mistake. This will be 6 and this will be 1/3 positive, not negative. I write correct, but on graph I might put something wrong. So one over two positive, not negative. So 6 is positive. We see all zeros has multiplicity 1. It means that graph intersect. Two turning points, 2, and that's it. This is a graph. Be attentive for sign. 1/3 positive, not negative. That's why it was. Okay, this is a graph. Now we will discuss homework number 4. So Esther will help me. Two students get points, Esther and Emmanuel. Okay, very good. I mark. Okay. Homework number 4. Page 133. Number 33. We should factor polynomial and mark zeros and say what is multiplicity and graph. x² - 36. Esther, how do we factor this?
So you factor by writing parentheses x + 6 and then parentheses x - 6.
Very good. Difference of squares. Very good. So we can see 2 zeros. What is multiplicity of this?
So the multiplicity is 1 because you only see the number 1.
It is not. Very good. It is 1 because no exponent of each factor is 1. And what does it mean about function? Function intersect the 0 or only touch?
It intersects.
Intersect. Is multiplicity is odd, 1 or 3. Then it intersect. Here we write approximately -36. We cannot be our graph. Intersect, very good. Y, x. Multiplicity of each 0 is 1. A function has minimum, because leading coefficient is positive 1, it has minimum, and 2 zeros, -6, +6. Very good. Number 35. H, C, equal t squared minus 6t plus 9. Okay, how do we factor this?
Okay, so I factored it by parentheses t minus 3 and then parentheses t minus 3.
Yes, or t minus 3 squared. We're going to square. That's okay. Or twice. Very good. Very good. That's why we cannot say one zero. It is two zeros, but they are equal. Okay, very good. And how do we graph this? What is multiplicity of this zero?
So it's going to be two.
Yes, multiplicity is two, even. And 1, 2, 3, positive 3, 9, this is 9, 1, 2, we write approximately 9, okay. And what can we say about graph? If multiplicity equal 2, how graph behave? It intersect x-axis or not?
No, it only touches it.
Only touch, excellent, very good. It's only touch, but doesn't intersect, not like this. Smooth curve, not acute angles, like smooth, it's only touch. This is symmetry axis. Symmetry axis will be x equals 3. We show this by dashed line. This is solid line y axis, and this is dashed line. It is symmetry axis, and this will be 9 and 9. Very good, very good. This is a graph. Multiplicity is even, 2. It means that if even, it means that function only touch x-axis, but doesn't intersect.
Mm-hmm.
Vertex is on x-axis. Mm-hmm. Number 39. Gx equal 5x x squared minus 2x minus 1. No, we have two factors, but we can solve quadratic equation. It cannot be factored. We use quadratic formula.
Mm-hmm.
How many? Plus minus square root of 4 plus 4. Plus 8. No, 8 square root of 8, we can simplify. It is 2 square root of 2. And we divide by 2, we get 1 plus minus square root of 2. That's our solutions. So it is real solution, but it is irrational solution. So we can present as 5x. X minus 1 plus square root of 2 times x plus, no, minus 1 minus square root of 2. That's it. Mm-hmm. 1 plus square root of 2, 1 minus square root of 2. This is zeros. Say me, what zeros this function has? What are zeros?
So the zeros are x equals 1 plus the square root of 2.
Mm-hmm.
And x equals 1 minus square root of 2. And x equals 0.
Excellent. Very good. It is 1 minus square root of 2, 0. And 1 plus square root of 2. This is 3 zeros. Okay. one. No, square root of two, it is approximately 1.4. It will be here, 0.4. And here will be one plus, it will be 2, 0.4, this will be, and zero. The leading coefficient is positive, 5x cubed. So we begin from negative infinity, come to the first zero. Then we come to origin, because y-intercept is origin. It passes through origin. Then it go to two turning points. That's it. This will be the sketch of graph. It's cubic. Mm-hmm. Behavior like x cubed. Mm-hmm. Leading coefficient is positive. Three zeros, two irrational and one zero. That's correct. Irrational also come in pairs, in conjugate pairs. Irrational, sorry. All zeros has multiplicity. What is multiplicity? What is multiplicity of all zeros?
It's the exponent of each of the factors.
It's one. It's one because exponent is one. Okay. It means that graph intersect. In zero, our graph intersect x-axis. We have two turning points. Mm-hmm. It's all zeros has multiplicity one, odd. Three x cubed. Minus 12. How do we factor this? How to factor?
The first thing I did was divide the function by 3.
By 3x. Very good. By 3x we divide.
Because, oh, by 3x.
Yes, common factor is 3x. And this will be x squared minus 4. Plus one, plus one. Okay, minus 4x. Mm-hmm. X squared minus 4x plus one. That's correct. Mm-hmm. We can, now we need to use quadratic formula. One zero is zero, origin. The function passes through origin. And so we use quadratic formula. 4 plus minus square root 16 minus 4. It will be square root of 12 over 2. And 12 can be simplified. It is 2 square root of 3. And we get 2. Plus minus square root of 3. Mm-hmm. And 0. Well, square root of 3, we can use calculator. How many is this? Square root of 3, approximately 1.76. Mm-hmm. So first will be 1 Ну, approximately minus 0.77. It will be our first. Then it is zero. And then it will be three. This will be another one. Three real zeros, but irrational. Irrational. Why? First coefficient is positive, leading coefficient is positive. Okay. Negative infinity, come to the first zero, then come to origin. To the second zero, this will be the graph. Very good, very good. Three zeros. Multiplicity is one because exponent is one. So three real zeros, two turning points, all zeros has multiplicity one at function intersect x-axis. That's it. Now the assignment is different. Now zeros are given and we need to write polynomial with the given zeros. Well, this is interesting. We use linear factorization theorem. We know if we know zeros, x minus zero is a factor. And this can have more than one solution. Number 55. Zero. Negative two. Negative four. Well, we can write x minus fx. Same, what will be the factors?
So it would be x minus the first zero, which is?
Yes, x, mm-hmm. X minus zero, x. Then.
And then x minus the second zero, and then the third, and then x minus the third zero.
Uh-huh, very good. Minus minus a plus. So it will be x plus two, x plus four, that's it. No, we can remove parentheses if you want. That's correct. This is easy. Now, number 59. Now it is a rational number. Now we have two. One plus square root of two, one minus square root of two. What is a polynomial?
So x minus one plus the square root of two, and then x minus one minus the square root of two.
Okay, now we will multiply. Multiply, what we get? We get x square, then we get x plus x times minus one minus square root of two. And then we get another x. Plus x minus one plus square root of two. And then we can the product one plus one minus. It is difference of squares. It is one minus two. Square root of two square, it is two. One minus two is negative one. Now we combine like terms, x square plus x, what for that? Minus one plus square root of two. Minus one minus square root of two. Square root of two cancel out. We get, and here we get minus one. And so we get x square minus two x minus one. That's it. This is a polynomial. X square. Well, if we multiply by any constant, the dearest will be the same. That's it. Next, two zeros are given and degree of polynomial is given. Number 67. Zero equal x equal minus three and degree of polynomial n equal two. Write the polynomial. If we have only one zero, but degree equal two, it means that both zeros are the same. Multiplicity is two. Same, what is the polynomial?
So since it's x equals minus three, it has to be x plus three.
Very good, minus three, it is x plus three.
Mm-hmm.
And what is the exponent?
And then the exponent is two because of the degree.
Okay, yes, it is x plus three square. Square. Oh, it's, we got x square plus six x plus nine. That's it. That's it. Very good. Very good. Uh-huh. 67. That's correct. Mm-hmm. Number 69. X, three zeros are given. X equal zero minus square root of three plus square root of three. You see, irrational always come in pairs. And n equal five. Degree of polynomial equal five. What is possible? No, total number of zeros should be equal to five. No, we can take x equals zero, gives it multiplicity three cube. We can write x minus, no, I will write f x equal x minus zero cube, because this give us only square. It will be x minus square root of three, x plus square root of three. It will be x square. Difference of squares, x square minus three, and here will be x cube. That's it. Or it will be x to the five, because degree is five, minus three, x cube. That's it. That's how we do it. Because if n equal five, we take real rational solution, multiplicity three, because irrational come in pairs. Another polynomial, which not the single solution, we can write like this, x, and this double x square minus three square. Also, the degree will be 5. X to the 4 and X. Each of this, we can give multiplicity 2. But it should be mandatory even number, even. It can be 2 or 4. Mm-hmm. Then it will be 0 minus 3 minus √3 plus √3 plus √3. Or it can be 0 3 times, and this only 1. But number of irrational solution also should be even, 2 or 4. It's 69. No, number 77. X cubed. Fx, x cubed minus 25x. Find all zeros and graph. Factor, how to factor? How to factor this?
Oh, I factored it as x, parentheses x minus 5. And very then good. Parentheses x plus 5.
Very good. X plus 5, x minus 5. Very good. And we have 3 zeros. It will be 0, it will be minus 5, and plus 5. Very good. Very good. Multiplicity is 1 because each factor only in degree 1. Now we can graph. It is the same as was our first, minus 5. But now it is cubic. It was square, now it is cubic. First coefficient is positive 1. We begin from negative infinity. Pass through 0. That's it. Mm-hmm. It is odd function. Cube. Mm-hmm. Number 81. Very good. FX.
Professor, I think you skipped number 77.
77? Oh. Maybe no, in money. And what you can give? What is 77? Say me. Maybe in this I didn't give it because now we have only twice a week. From my previous assignment, I exclude some of them. I will check. 77 we have. It's the same is a problem. What is the problem?
Number. So 77 is f of x equals 3x squared minus 15x squared. No, sorry, 3x cubed, sorry. Mm-hmm. So 3x cubed minus 15x squared.
Mm-hmm.
Plus 18x.
Very good. Okay, show me how to do it. How to factor.
So how to factor? I divided it by 3.
3x. common factor. Greatest common factor is 3x. 3x, very good. X squared minus 5x plus 6. That's what we'll. And so first factor will be 0, actually, well, the function possible origin. And then we can factor this trinomial. It will be x plus 6, 2 and 3. X minus 2, x minus 3. That's it. And our zeros will be 0, 2, 3. Mm-hmm. And our graph, 1. Our graph will be 0. Behavior like x cubed, 2, 3, 3. 1, 2, 0. It comes to 3. Then it comes to 2. Then it comes to 0. That's it. 3, 2, 0. Very good. Very good. Thank you. Thank you. I need this. Okay. Number 81. So we should pay attention on behavior for large axes, leading coefficient positive. It increase from negative infinity to positive infinity, and it pass through 3 zeros. Greatest common factor is 3x. Mm-hmm. 81. 9x squared. X plus 2 cube. Now we see multiplicity is not 1. It is even, it is odd. Even means that function does not intersect x-axis, only touch, as you say. And odd means that it intersects. It is already factored. We can graph 0, negative 2. Cube means that the degree of polynomial is 5, odd. Leading coefficient is positive, so it increases from negative infinity. Come to negative 2 like this. Intercept. Then it comes back to 0, only touch. Because it is square. It is multiplicity equal to, it means that it touch, don't intersect, and go up. That's a function. Here we get inflection point like this. A little bit along the x-axis. And multiplicity will be 2 and 3, 0. It only touch, don't intersect, and negative 2, it intersect. That's a function, 81. 83. GT. 1, negative 1 over. X minus 2 squared. plus 2 squared. Where is it? G minus 2, G plus 2 squared. Now both zeros has multiplicity even 2. It means that only touch. Negative 2, positive 2. And leading coefficient is negative. Degree is 4, 2 plus 2, 4. Leading coefficient negative. It means that function has maximum. When it will be maximum, when t equals 0. Equals 0, both positive and this negative. Uh-huh. When t equals 0, it will be 4 times 4, 16. Over 4, it will be negative 4. No, behavior for large will be like negative x squared. It will be like this. Come to negative 2. Only touch, don't intersect. Go to minimum value, negative 4. Go to positive 0, only touch, don't intersect, and go to negative. That's it. This is the sketch. Y, x. This function is even. Leading coefficient is negative. We have two maximums, one minimum, three turning point. Okay, let's see. This is a graph. That's it. Now we use remainder theorem. We need to substitute. Do synthetic division, find the remainder, or find or substitute the value in function. Not the right page. X cube minus x square minus 10x plus 7. And we need to find k equals 3. It is remainder for if we divide by x minus 3. Now let us use synthetic division. Make sure that everybody can do it. Synthetic division, we should be able to do plus 7. 3. This is very easy. 1. Two. Negative 5. Remainder is negative 5. Let us check. let us substitute 3 in our function. What we get? 3 cube, it is 27, minus 3 square, it's minus 9, minus 30, plus 7. 27 plus 7, this is 34, minus 39. It is negative 5, correct. Remainder theorem is true, we make sure. The remainder of division by x minus 3 is negative 5, and the value f of 3 is also negative 5. It is 45, 46. It's the same thing. I will do synthetic division. 1, negative 4, negative 10, 8. Negative 2, 1. Everybody know how to do synthetic division. Minus 4. Let us check. Minus 4, minus 10, plus 8, 2, negative 2, negative 8, negative 2 is 4, negative 16, plus 4, 20. Plus 8. That's correct. Plus 4. Because it is negative 24 plus 28. Equals 4. That's correct. Now we have polynomial number 51. F1 and F of minus 2. Negative. Correct. Minus 2. Minus 8, it will be negative 16, plus 14, plus 3, equal 1. Well, remainder theorem is true. Number 55. We need to factor completely. plus 6x plus 11x plus 6. X equal negative 7. No, it is given. 1x is given. 1, 0 is given. How to find all factors? We find divide by x plus 3. We can do synthetic division. 1, 6. Some people try to do factoring. We should be able to do synthetic division. It is easier. Minus 3. Квадратик. Quotient equal x squared plus 3x plus 2 equals 0. Now this can be factored. X plus 1, x plus 2. Product is 2, sum is 3. And we have all 3 zeros. That's it, we factor completely. It is equal x plus 3, x plus 2, x plus 1. Number 59, we have irrational here. We will not do synthetic division with irrational numbers. What we do, we know that irrational solutions always come in conjugate pairs. It means that minus square root of 3 is also. To find the 3, should be 3 zeros. How to find the third zero? What should we do? Well, we have factor x minus square root of 3, it is given. Another factor, what is another factor, Esther? Square root of 3 and minus square root of 3 is also a factor. What is a factor? Minus minus. It will be plus. Plus square root of 3. And what will be the quadratic factor? It is difference of squares. Minus and plus, it will be x squared minus 3. We will do long division. To find the third factor, we will do long division. We also should be able to do x squared minus 3. Do long division. What is the third factor? The x cube. And when we divide, we should write 0. 0, we write x square plus 0 x minus 3. 0 x square minus 3x. Minus plus 2x square minus 6x square minus 6. And when we divide 2x square divided by x square, we get plus 2. X plus 2. That's it. Quotient will be x plus 2. It means that the real equal, the 0 equal x minus 2. Now we find all zeros. Now we can factor completely. Fx equal x squared minus 3 x plus 2. Or we can write like this, x minus square root of 3 x plus square root of 3, x plus 2. That's it. That's how. Or we factor completely. Now all factors are real, but they are irrational. Number 63. Two factors are given, and we need to find the third factor. Well, we can do synthetic division twice. All right, number 67. Either we can do long division once or synthetic division twice. Let us do synthetic. 2, 1, minus 5. 2 divided by 1. Two, three, minus two, zero. Now we write 2, 3, minus 2 divided by -2. -2, -4, -1, +2, 0. So we get 2x. -1. So 0 equal x equal 1/2. Now we factor completely. It is 2x -1. X minus 1, x plus 2. No, at number 79, we should do long division. Both procedure should be, we should be able to do both procedure, long division and synthetic division. Plus 6x cubed plus 11x squared plus 6x. And we divide by x squared plus 3x plus 2.
Professor, did you take attendance?
Not yet. X squared. Multiply x to the 4 plus 3 x cubed plus 2 x squared. Change sign, cancel, 3x squared plus 9, 3x cubed plus 9x squared plus 6x, divide by x squared, we'll get plus 3x, 3x cubed. Plus 9x squared plus 6x. That's it. Remainder is 0. So that's it. We simplify. When we divide, we get x squared plus 3x. We can check. If we multiply, we get numerator. That's it. So I hope both procedure should be able, we should be able to do. Okay, very good, Esther, very good, very good. Now, what I will do, now I will give you short quiz to do now, and then I will take attendance. I will write on the board, polynomial of third degree, exactly the same as we did before. We find real zero, do synthetic division, get quadratic equation, then solve quadratic equation, find all zeros and graph. The fx equal, and then graph. Minus, we have half an hour for this. 3x squared plus 2, pay attention on leading coefficient, it is negative, minus. Minus 3x squared. Plus 2x squared plus 3x minus 2. Ну, if we look at this polynomial, it is easy. We see immediately that 0 is 1 because the sum of coefficients is 0. If we substitute x equal 1, we will get 0. So we can do synthetic division. It is easy. So do division and find all zeros. Graph. Graph fx. That's what we need. I give you half an hour. And you can send me before 1 p.m. Send to my email. Write quiz one. It is quiz one. The similar problem will be in our midterm. Midterm will be in 2 weeks. It will be July 14, not July 12, July 14, quiz one. Polynomial of 3x cubed, 3x cubed, 2x squared, 3x minus 2. Let's find all zeros and graph. Graph, please make same spaces. Write numbers 1, 2, 3. This and do approximately the same spaces. Show y intercept. Y intercept and x intercept. Now we will take attendance. Please copy the problem. Copy the problem. I will leave the screen. Everybody copy the problems. Okay, now I see the screen. Okay, okay. Kagan Hitchcock. Hitchcock. I will leave the screen.
Oh, Professor, Hitchcock is not in today. He said he can make it.
Ah, he said he will not be. Okay, okay, yes. Okay, then. Uh-huh. Caitlin here. I say Caitlin here.
Yeah.
Okay. Emmanuel here. You get points today. Very
good.
Okay. Michael. Karasik Michael.
I'm here.
Uh-huh. David. Here.
Here.
Here. Okay. Ilya. Here.
Here.
Yeah. Here. Sarah. Here. Sarah, I see you. Uh-huh. Here. Nicole. Nicole. Here, Nicole.
I'm here, Professor. Here. I'm here.
Okay. Joseph, here.
I'm here.
Today, very good. Perfect attendance. Jose, here. Jose. No? Jose. Here, okay. Esther, here. Esther, very good today. Presentation and points, very good. Uh-huh. Who will do presentation next time? Who won? No volunteers. No, maybe I. Ilya, can you do next time? Answer some questions. You sent homeworks. Ilya. No. Who else? Sarah. Schiffman, Sarah. Sarah. You was here, your answer. Maybe people leave. No, later. Okay, we will do the end. Maybe somebody who want to do presentation. It is 10 points. It is easy. Again, no, everybody should have. You want, who want? Ah, Jose, you want again? We will try, maybe somebody. If nobody, okay, you can again. If nobody wants.
Let's talk up.
Who?
Oh, I'm sorry.
You also want again. You already did. I want somebody who did not do. Maybe David, maybe you. David.
Next time, Professor.
Who? David? Okay, I will write. You will do next time. Very good.
Professor, if we did the quiz, should we send it?
Yes, send to my email as you.